Welcome to the video news of the week. Following on the heels of the Colebrook Select Board issuing a statement that it is now neutral on the Northern Pass project, while at the same time seemingly commending Northern Pass's Forward New Hampshire Fund, this week the North Country Chamber of Commerce reversed its stance of opposing the controversial power line, instead saying as an intervener it will now not take a formal position on the project. This has not sat well with some members of the North Country Chamber Board of Directors, which took a vote on Wednesday morning to issue its new neutrality statement to the media. Two board members resigned during the meeting before the vote. The Colebrook Chronicle verified through North Country Chamber President Wayne Frizzell that two members have left the board. On checking the chamber's website, it can be noted that the names of both Columbia resident Bob Baker and Pittsburgh resident Steve Ellis are no longer on the current roster. A third member, Jamie Sion of Stratford, reached out to the Chronicle after the vote to voice his displeasure with the vote, calling it, quote, illegitimate. At the center of the objection over the vote is what some call a lobbying campaign by Balsam's developer Les Otten to change the chamber's previous opposition to Northern Pass. Wednesday's statement to the media from the North Country Chamber of Commerce President Wayne Frizzell read in part, quote, we represent members who are both in favor and opposed to the Northern Pass project. Therefore, we would like to be listed as neutral interveners and be the conduit for sharing information to our members. Look for more on this story in this week's Colebrook Chronicle. 2 weeks ago, the mayor of the city of Manchester, Ted Gatsas, announced his campaign as a Republican candidate for New Hampshire governor. We sat down with Gatsas for an interview when he came through town this past Saturday.
In the past, I've served in the Senate, and I was the Senate president. And certainly at that time, it was about working with folks together to get problems solved. Mm-hmm. City of Manchester, I've won four terms there, got an awful lot of things done, and thought it was time to go back to Concord right. to bring my experience and my leadership up there so we could get some things done. And try and get the state back into a position that we all are talking and doing great things. We've reduced the size of our budget. As a matter of fact, I presented a budget on Tuesday and got a standing ovation from all the aldermen. So that means that we work together and we get things done. This heroin epidemic that we had mm-hmm. is something that's hitting this entire state, the entire country. We need to change the penalty that if you're caught dealing heroin, we're gonna arrest you for attempted murder. Mm-hmm. And we need to make sure that the bails are raised so that somebody doesn't get arrested on a Tuesday and they're back out on the street on Thursday dealing drugs. I would say to you, it's the biggest problem, and it's the problem that can affects more families mm-hmm. than you can possibly imagine. The folks in this state are granite hard, and they're as tough as you can find them. You give them opportunities, they take advantage of it. Right. If you give them problems, they solve them. So I can tell you that whether you're here in the North Country, and yes, it's a little tougher here in the North Country, mm-hmm. and if we could get some booming economic demand here, I think you would change it. I think we can do that again. I think the Balsams are going to be that big play in this North Country to bring economic demand back. Met a lot of good people today, got an awful lot of good support. Well, they're talking about Northern Pass, and I'm saying let's not make the same mistakes we made mm-hmm. when we sold Seabrook, the power plant, the nuclear plant. You know, if we'd have kept 20% of the power in this state at that time, we wouldn't be talking about some of the highest electric rates in the country. So with the power that's coming down from Canada, let's keep 30% at the low rate right here in this state. Let's bury it, and then let's talk about it. If you can come up with a better idea and the people that it's affecting are okay with it, then that's a whole different issue. But my feeling right now is let's bury it, let's keep 30% of the whole thing, and let's keep 30% of the power right here in this state.
You can read the full interview in this week's Colebrook Chronicle.
Stratford School welcomed the newest member of the school's National Junior Honor Society in a ceremony on Tuesday afternoon. Kayla Rose Howland was inducted into the organization by current member Amanda Newman. The guest speaker for the ceremony was middle school teacher David Atkins.
I'd like to start by offering my congratulations to the new inductee, Kayla, and to the existing member. I also want to congratulate their parents, families, and the staff members here at Stratford who are part of the reason why these students are sitting up here in front of you.
Kayla Rose, it takes great pleasure for me to give you your certificate of membership in the National Junior Honor Society and your membership.
To maintain and encourage.
To maintain and encourage.
The high standards.
The high standards.
Of character.
Of character.
Scholarship.
The Colebrook Recreation Drama Club is at it again with their latest production, an adapted performance of Disney's Peter Pan, performed last Saturday and Sunday at the Tillotson Center in Colebrook.
Peter, the leader, the leader, we're off on an adventure to capture Indian scouts.
This feels kind of silly.
Yeah. We native braves have fought with you lost boys.
True.
Sometimes you win, sometimes we win.
Okay, you win this time. Turn us loose.
Turn us loose? You mean this is only a game?
Yeah, and it sometimes feels a little ridiculous to talk like that. But there was one important matter.
Sunbeams at sea.
Look, the mermaids of Neverland. I have to meet them.
But Wendy, gotta find Hook.
Who are you, stranger?
I am James Hook, captain of the Jolly Roger.
But if you are Hook, then who am I?
A codfish.
The Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating, over 85 years of local dependable service. Call 237-8301 for heating, plumbing, and electrical needs. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank, and open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Friday's weather brings a mix of rain and snow with temps ranging from a high of 40 degrees to a low of 21. Saturday clears up with a high of 32, and Sunday temps range from a high of 33 to a low of 19 degrees. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.